There is a wooden bench, a blanket, no pillow. There are four walls, and a tiny window high up. And through the bars, I can see the black night. And three stars. There is no sign of dawn yet, no creeping light. But I have no wish to sleep, to waste my last few hours on this earth. I want only to remember things, to remember Angel Clare, and to watch the sky as it changes. The first time I ever saw him was several years ago, and it was May Day. All of us wore white that day, but no two whites were alike. Some had a bluish look. Others were slightly yellow, as if they'd been folded up and stored away for too long. We each carried a willow wand in our right hand and a bunch of white flowers in our left. I was the only one to wear a ribbon in my hair, and the ribbon was red. We came by the Pure Drop Inn and turned out of the high road to pass through the gate into the meadows.
Riding home with a carriage?
I'm not sure.
It is.
And so it was. I could see him moving along the road in a chaise that belonged to the Pure Drop, leaning back with his eyes closed, waving his hand above his head and singing.
What's he singing?
Something about knighted forefathers.
Knighted forefathers?
He's just tired and he probably got a lift because our own horse has to rest because he has to drive to market at midnight.
Tessie, he's been at the bottle.
He's drunk as a lord.
Stop it. Stop it now. I won't walk another step with you if you talk about him that way.
Oh, sorry, Tess.
We didn't mean anything by it.
Please walk with us.
Well, if you leave now, you'll miss the dancing.
All right.
As there were no men, we danced at first with each other.
Excuse me?
I can still picture him leaning on the gate as he called to us.
What is the meaning of the dance? And why are you all dressed alike?
It is the Marlott Walking Club, sir.
The Marlott Walking Club?
We're celebrating May Day.
I see. Oh, thank you for the explanation.
He had the look of a student, and you could tell that he was educated. From the way he spoke.
Come on, Angel, you have your answer.
Wait a moment.
Why?
I might stay and dance.
What for?
For the fun of it.
Nonsense. We have to reach Star Castle before it's dark.
Well, I wouldn't dance for long.
What if someone saw you?
What if they did?
You can't abandon all propriety, you know, Angel. Just because you plan to be a farmer and not a parson.
Ha! Well, I'll catch up with you. In 5 minutes, I give you my word.
He leapt over the gate when he could just as easily have opened it. And his two older brothers left him and walked on. The young man had fair hair, and he smiled easily.
This is a thousand pities. Where are your partners?
They've not left off work yet. They'll be here by and by.
Till then, will you be one, sir?
Certainly. But what's one amongst so many?
Better than none, sir.
Now you must choose one of us.
Don't be so forward.
Pick me, pick me, pick me. I prayed inside. But his eyes passed over me without seeing, and he simply chose the nearest girl.
When 4 o'clock comes, then up we do.
Soon enough, the young men of the village arrived, and then we all had a masculine partner, but none as good as the stranger who spoke so well.
We're all jolly fellows who follow the plough.
I'm forgetting myself. I should go, or I will never catch up with my brothers.
Well, thank you for dancing with us, sir.
Yes, thank you for the dance, sir.
It was a pleasure.
He turned to leave then, and I broke off from the group as if to follow him. That's when he saw me.
Hello.
Hello.
That's the wrong thing to say. Sorry, just as I was leaving. Goodbye is what I should say. Yes. Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
I watched him go, and he looked back at me as he crossed the field. Not once, but twice. and the second time he waved at me, and I half waved back. Then he jumped over the gate and went flying down the lane westward. I could hear his footsteps as he ran. When later I returned home to my father's cottage, the contrast was striking. From the scene in the field with the white dresses, the flowers, the whirling movements on the green, the young stranger who spoke so nicely, to this room, the dingy yellow candlelight, the wet washing, the children.
Oh, Tess, did you enjoy your dancing?
Yes.
I expect all the young men all wanted to dance with you.
Not all of them.
You're just being modest, I know. Oh, no. Hush, little poppet.
I'll change out of this frock and I'll help you finish the wash.
I'm going to take the baby. Try and get him to sleep.
All right.
I want to go and fetch your father. But first, I've got to tell you all that's gone on.
All that's gone on this afternoon?
Oh, yes, you'll be amazed, Tessie.
Has it anything to do with Father making such a show of himself in the carriage this afternoon?
That was part of it, yes.
But what could possibly...
You shan't guess. So, let me tell you.
All right.
We have been found to be the greatest gentlefolk in the whole of Wessex.
What?
Oh, yes. Reaching all the way back before Oliver Cromwell's time.
Oliver Cromwell.
That's what I said.
Who's Oliver Cromwell?
Abraham. You should know from school.
But I don't, so who is he?
We had monuments and vaults and crests and the Lord knows what else. We was Knights of the Royal Oak. And our name is D'Urberville. Don't that make you feel proud?
I'm not sure. How did he hear this news?
From the parson, on his way home from Stour Castle. Tess, your father went to see the doctor today.
What did the doctor say?
It's not consumption, after all, it seems. It's his heart.
His heart?
Doctor said to him, you might last 10 years. Or you might go off in 10 months, or even 10 days.
10 days?
Oh, don't look so frightened. Might be 10 years if we're lucky.
Where's Father now?
Now, don't you be bursting out angry. The poor man, he felt so weak after this news that he went up to Oliver's.
Oh, he didn't.
He needs to get his strength up.
Get his strength up?
For his journey tomorrow with the beehives. He'll have to start just after midnight.
So why is he at the public house?
What did I say about bursting out angry?
I'll go and fetch him now.
No, I'll go. You stay here with these lot. I'll not be long, all right?
But it grew later, and neither my father nor my mother reappeared. Abraham, will you go up to Rolliver's?
Aye.
Bring them back quickly, Abraham. Father has to start out at midnight.
All right.
But half an hour passed and no one returned. Liza Lou?
Yes?
Abraham hasn't been able to bring them home. I must go myself. You go to bed and I'll lock you in, all right?
All right.
You won't be afraid, will you?
No.
It was easy enough to get them out of the public house once they saw my sorrowful look. But no
Thank
easy
God
thing to get my father home.
Bolt at Kingsby.
Hush, Father.
Hush, Jackie.
Why should I, Hush? Why should I?
I'm afraid he won't be able to make the journey with the beehives tomorrow.
What? Who says?
It's as clear as day.
But it's not, Tessie. It's dark, dark as night. Look.
I like seeing the stars.
Oh, the stars, the stars, the stars.
Oh, steady, Jack.
I'm all right.
No,
but how will you drive to the market, Father?
I shall be all right in an hour or two. Don't you worry.
It was 11 before we were all in bed. And 2 o'clock in the morning was the latest anyone could leave and still reach Casterbridge in time for the Saturday market. Sure enough, my mother crept into the room I shared with my brothers and sisters.
The poor man can't go. Tessie's too ill.
But somebody must go.
Might we wait till next week?
No one will want the bees next week.
But what can we do?
It's late for the hives already. I think I could go.
You? All alone?
Perhaps Abraham would come with me to keep me company.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.